Welcome, and thank you for tuning in for the Partnership Lake Houston Summer Creek BizCom. I'm Dwayne Johnston, the owner of Chick-fil-A Wilson Road and Beltway 8, and the chairman of Summer Creek BizCom Committee. We are grateful that you've chosen to spend an hour with us today, and we look forward to sharing updates from many community members. For our Zoom guests, you will notice that you are muted, and of all guests will remain muted throughout the entire program. If you have any questions or need assistance, please use the Q&A function located at the bottom of your screen. If you're joining us on Facebook Live, you can submit a question in the comment section, and we will submit it to our Zoom meeting platform for the speakers. We have a lot of knowledgeable panelists to cover a multitude of topics today. So without further ado, our panelists today are Gonzalo. He's with the Director of Design and Planning with McCord Development. He's going to present information on Generation Park Trail Park Network and a timeline for future development along the west side of Generation Park. We also have Dr. Melissa Gonzalez, the new president of Lone Star College, Kingwood. She's going to provide an introduction and we're going to welcome her and introduce her to the community. We have Brent McDonald, principal of Summer Creek High School. He's going to provide some plans and updates for the 2021 and 22 school year and update the community on news and happenings at Summer Creek High School. We also have Reese McCall, the general manager of the Golf Club of Houston, to provide us an update of what's going on at the Golf Club of Houston and plans for the future. We have Brooke Ball, with Partnership Lake Houston, about the Houston Partnership Lake Houston's Golf Classic and our party on the green. As always, we depend on our business sponsors to make programs like BizCom available for our members and the Greater Lake Houston area community. Summer Creek BizCom sponsors include our gold sponsors, Chick-fil-A Wilson Road and Beltway 8, HEB Summer Creek, JLA Realty with Team Amanda Petrie, K&S Sportswear, McCord Development Generation Park, and MD Anderson Cancer Centers. Our silver sponsors are PostNet Summerwood and Shell Federal Credit Union. If your business is interested in being a sponsor, please contact Partnership Lake Houston. Your sponsorship funds support the efforts of Partnership Lake Houston, which enables us to help businesses recover and succeed. Now more than ever, small businesses need the help and resources and the guidance that partnership can provide. If your business has not been negatively impacted by the pandemic, please consider sponsoring or a program or sponsor a membership for another small business. So, our first speaker today is going to be Gonzalo. He's the Director of Design and Planning with McCord Development. Gonzalo again is here today to speak to us about Generation Park Trail, the Trail Park Network, and some more future developments that's going on in Generation Park. Welcome, Gonzalo.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. I'm super excited to be in this session and being able to present, you know, what we're doing and to share with the community and to share with all of you all the big plans we have in line and in mind, you know, at Generation Park. So I will share the screen. I have a couple of images that I would like to share with you guys. Let's see, this works. So I'm gonna start, I don't know if everyone can see, you know, that I think you do. So I'm gonna start with the overall picture of Generation Park. As you know, like we are like a 4,200 acre land. We are now concentrated on developing a third of the land, which is the area that is to the west of Beltway 8, which is, you know, this section that you see in here to the west. And so on this section, what we are doing today is that we're building a series of roads and little neighborhoods. As you know, a Redemption Square has been built, and we're like, you know, starting, you know, next year with the second phase to the south, providing more multi-use. And other uses, you know, in that area linked to commercial uses. And also we're opening Westlake Park to the west, which is fully built. And so we have where IKEA is and Lincoln Properties, and we have other good industrial and production uses in that area. With that, we are developing a park to the south, which is this section, you know, this park, which is a park that we will provide enough fishes, you know, for people to come and fish. And we're moving with Generation Parkway to starting, you know, move to the east and generating all these parks and ponds, which are gonna be taking care of all the stormwater that we need to take care in the area. So this is a very creative way of us, you know, taking care of the stormwater and providing a tons of parks in the area. And so as you can see, and I will jump into like another plan I have here that will be aware with you, which is which is a little bit more in detail, a plan of what we are doing in Generation Park West. And as you can see in this plan and at a very broad outlook here, like this, you know, we're providing, you know, space for distribution, research, production, education, entertainment, sports. We're allowing, you know, like a lot of areas for good sports, health, life science, and of course, recreation. And with that, I wanted to jump into the loop, the trail loop that we're starting to build now. We're building it, but we will deliver that very soon for the community. And so what that is doing is that the strategy is that we're creating a trail system in the west side that will be linked to everywhere. Will be linked to the north, the east, the west, south. But what we're making sure is that trail system becomes the backbone of this community. So whoever comes to Generation Park would love to move around, not by car, but by option, will choose to use the trail. And so they can hop on the trail and get to anywhere they need to go. And the strategy is, I will share with you guys, is the strategy is here, you know, based on what you just saw on the other map. We have a trail network. As you can see here, we have the red line, which we're calling the loop. And so this loop is connecting everything around Generation Park West. And we are like throwing lines, you know, to connect to Fall Creek, to connect to Summerwood, to connect to Generation Park East, and absolutely connecting to the communities to the north. And so with that, we took a bigger approach to the area, into the area, thinking that any trail approach deserves a more holistic approach of the area, because we need to understand where we're located. And so we generate this map. And I will zoom in a little bit because it's a very interesting map, the one we're creating. This is work in progress. But what we see here is our region. You see Lake Houston, you see our land, Generation Park, but also you see the parks that are surrounding us. We have Sheldon, Dusen, Eisenhower, Greens Bayou, and its old system. Then clearly, you know, all the open space that Fall Creek provides, plus the golf course, and a sequence of little parks and systems that are like, are being built or they're already there, and they're starting to get connected throughout the area of Lake Houston area. Even St. Jacinto River has a potential, you know, to become a pretty interesting place for everyone. And so if I zoom in, what we're trying to do here is that we are trying to show that by connecting, you can connect to all the essential activities that you need during your day, like shopping, education, recreation, and offices and workplace. And so by doing this graphic, it's creating a conscious of how much do we have in the area, which is it's very special and very exciting. As you can see, and I will zoom a little bit by parts, is that we right now at Generation Park, we are very close to Fall Creek, what's going on with Fall Creek and all the green system that is being developed and financed already in there, to Dusen Park and Eisenhower, which are receiving a good amount of investment from Precinct One, and the systems like Sheldon State Park to the south, and all the systems that are going to be developed to the south and hopefully future to the north. Which means that we will be able to move around the area in an alternative mode, not just by car, but through trails. And these are these are ideas, we just control the area that we are in, but we're suggesting good connections throughout the community, connections that can go south, and connecting all the high schools and middle school and elementary schools, community colleges that we have in the area, Lone Star in Generation Park, and then we have Lone Star, Westlake Park, Houston, plus all the other high schools. And if we keep going north, and as I'm saying, this is we're adding the Atascocita Trail, we're adding existing trails. We see that we can get to 1960, we can get to the areas that we already know, and reaching all the way up to Kingwood and convert the area, and then really to Humboldt in one interesting area that will be connected through a trail system. The concept that comes with this is a very interesting concept that many cities are using throughout the world, especially after what just happened or is happening today with COVID-19, and the ability of taking public transportation, or just the ability of just going outside and riding your bike and just moving by yourself and getting what you need within the time, within the distance you need. So it has been measured, 15-minute city is a concept that has been developed, over time, but now it's very, very strong around the world. Cities like Paris, Melbourne are really taking it very seriously. And so we believe, that places like ours would be able to achieve something like that by a good connectivity. So we measured the 15-minute city through this diagram, as you can see in here, and I will zoom in there. We measure different distances. We have the 5-minute walk, which is really, we're referencing based on Generation Park, but because we're doing this exercise, but we can move things around easily. But this is a good way to measure distances around the region. Because what we are creating here is within 5-minute walk, meaning that you from one point to the center, you will just take 5 minutes to walk. But which is interesting is that the 15-minute walk, will extend you. You will start touching, some areas of Summerwood, and then you will start reaching some neighborhoods, just surrounding neighborhoods of Generation Park. What makes this a little bit more interesting is that when you extend the concept to the 15-minute city to the bikes, which many cities are doing, you start to reach out to a broader area, which gets all the way to Eagle Springs, the Groves, all the way down to all the parks that are surrounding us to the east, plus a full Fall Creek all the way to the golf course. and golf club, sorry. And so if we keep talking about the 15-minute city and how advantages to like make sure that we can provide a system for that, we can take, you know, like a 15-minute city dimension if we use any scooter or e-bike, which cities like Seattle and other cities are implementing, which places us in a very interesting situation. And so here in red, as you can see, all the lines are all the potential connections. They're like some existing, the ones that are like in red, and then hatch are like the potential connections that are like in study or in progress. And we are not, we haven't collected enough information towards a humble area, but it's clearly showing that we could become a pretty interesting place where you have everything that you need within 15 minutes. And not using your car, but using another way of mobility, micro-mobility as it is called. So by walking or by bike, you will be able to reach any service you need because we have it all. We have it all in the area. We have the hospitals. We have, you name it, all the things that you might need in your life in an area, you might have it. So, which is something interesting to position ourselves like this because everyone realized how difficult it is to commute by not commuting. So when people stopped commuting last year, everyone realized that they got back several hours in the day for their own use. And so that's a concept that we would love to explore and share with the rest of the community. So there are a couple of projects that we have in mind right now. We're calling it, you know, the Northeast Line, which is this one that connects, you know, along the railway, not using the railway right of way, but it could be north or south, which will create a sequence of stations, you know, stations like that will be part of the trail. We're calling them stations, but are like connecting points that will be able to connect the community. So we'll make sure that from this point, you know, all the way to Westlake Park Houston, you know, to when touches, you know, the Parkway area or the Groves, from there to this point, you will be 15 minutes away in a bike ride, not even crossing a road. So it's like not even crossing a street, which is a big deal when a community is able to connect itself without crossing any road, just, you know, by trails. It takes you to a different level, different type of community. And then there's another project that we're starting also to develop, which is the connectivity to Fall Creek. And Fall Creek has received good amount of money to develop the trail system, to continue developing the trail systems. And we would love to connect, you know, to Fall Creek and make sure that we all become one by connecting through Generation Park, or like if Fall Creek wants to connect to Lake Houston, parks, they can do it in 30 minutes, you know, by bike ride. So that's a little bit of, you know, where we are. We wanted to share, you know, with this group, where we're standing in relation to our planning efforts and how things that we're taking in consideration when talking about trail systems. And so that would be, I don't know if there's any questions, you know, that I can answer, but that's that.
Thanks, Gonzalo. That is great information. I know a big desire that Generation Park has had is to help, I think we all have in this area, is to help make this area a place where we can live, work, eat, and play. And right. Hearing about that trail network, I've already seen y'all's trail around Westlake Lake right down there y'all made. It's constantly got people walking around there and enjoying those facilities. And so looking forward to having those trails systems developed. Just a quick two questions for clarification. When that's all completed and the kind of the dream that you have right now, about how many miles of trail network would that be?
Oh, that's a good question, because you know our first loop is 4 miles, you know, like the inner loop. So you just multiply that by 10 minimum, you know. So like I will be thinking that we will have no less than, you know, 50 miles very soon of trails.
Well, that's great. We are so looking forward to that coming along. And then the one other question or kind of clarification that came up, I know a lot of listeners may have heard you mention IKEA, and I just, for clarification, y'all might, everybody wants to remember, that's just a distribution center, correct? That there's nothing else that's come along
correct,
with that.
Correct.
That's just maybe their distribution, yeah, where they're shipping things through and things, correct?
IKEA made the decision of focusing on distribution centers because that's where they're making the money. And so, yeah, it's a big distribution center for the region.
Gotcha. Awesome. Well, again, thanks for coming and sharing that information with us today. We are looking forward to those trails coming along, and we will be eagerly waiting for those to open up.
You're so welcome.
Next up, we have the new president of Lone Star College Kingwood, Dr. Melissa Gonzalez. There's a lot of things going on at the college, and when we heard about her selection in this role, we wanted to bring her here and welcome her to the community. I also know that she's a local Fall Creek, Summer Creek resident down here. So we're really excited to get to hear from you, Dr. Gonzalez. So please let us know how things are going.
Hello, everyone. I am so sorry that you can't see me, but I did want to share some wonderful things that are happening at Lone Star College. Oh, there I am. again, I'm so excited to be here. I am a local. My family and I moved to the Humble Fall Creek area about 3 years ago. So we're so excited to be here. We moved from downtown Houston, but again, it's amazing to live here, do business here, go to school here, and now I work here. So it's a win-win-win-win for all of us. So again, thank you so much. I'm so excited to be here. Just a great opportunity to be an advocate for education right here in my community, in our community. And everyone has been so welcoming. Everyone has been so very embracing me. And again, I'm just so happy to be here. So thank you so much. I will start my presentation. This great opportunity to share about Lone Star College in general. I just want to share just a little bit. If people don't know, Lone Star College is we have about 93,000 students in a year, and that's including credit and non-credit students. So it's a huge organization. We're one of the top three largest colleges in the nation. We have 7 colleges here with 12 centers. So we have about 19 areas that we are actually teaching and offering opportunities for our community. We work with 11 school districts. We are the top 5 associate degree producer, ranked 3rd. And we're also named one of the great colleges to work for, and that's 4th year in a row. So we're very proud of that. We are one of the first, and we want to thank Senator Creighton for helping us. We're offering 3 bachelor degree programs. So it's not just associate degrees that we're in. We're also doing workforce bachelor degree programs in cybersecurity, energy manufacturing and trains management, and also a nursing degree, bachelor's degree. So again, great things. This is Lone Star College as a system. Now, talking about Kingwood, again, this is where I'm the new president. Again, so very excited. We have about 12,000 to 13,000 students. And, you know, we have about 930 employees. Our campus is just beautiful. If you ever want to come and do a tour, we'd love to share all the great things that we're doing here. We also have a career center, veterans, intercultural men's, women's center. And we're the only college that services 5 school districts. So we have a lot of communities to serve with Humboldt, Tarkington, New Caney, Splendora, and Cleveland. I just want to share the amazing programs that we have here. Whether you're interested in a workforce program, in computer gaming or cosmetology, we have visual communication, we have fire science, computer technology, nursing, respiratory therapy, I could go on and on. But we also have numerous continuing education programs like medical billing and coding, EMT, certified nursing assistant, dental assistant, accounting. Maybe you want to learn some Photoshop or web page creation. We have all those programs too. So whether you want a short little certificate that you can complete in a few weeks to semester program or a level one certificate that you can do in a year, or a two-year associate degree where you want to transfer to a four-year university. We have all those opportunities right here at Lone Star College Kingwood. And we also have, like, if you want to, we have offer GED classes, English classes as well. So again, we have everything for everyone here at Lone Star College Kingwood. I just want to share just real quick about my priorities, or I guess the priorities for Kingwood is about student success. We're going to do everything we can for anyone who wants to change their lives in a positive way through higher education. We are here to serve our community and our students. And how do we do that? We need to strengthen our relationships and partnerships with everybody that we can. Alone, we can't do it, but we all have the same dream, you know, making sure that we have an educated workforce, we have an educated community, and we can do that starting right here with Lone Star College. We're partnering with our cities, with our counties, with our school districts, business, community, and faith-based organizations, and of course, industry. Gonzalo, I mean, I thank you so much. We are working with you to be part of that stop there at Lockwood at Generation Park. We're working with the county as well. We're working with cities to provide opportunities at their location. So again, it is a working together to make things happen. We are doing grassroots. I know a lot of social media, I understand all that, that is great, but there's a lot of people that we're not reaching. So we're doing some grassroots promotions of all our academic and workforce programs, including our student support services and resources, because it's all good to be able to offer programs in nursing and process technology and so forth. But we also have to share that we also have tutoring. We have a partnership with the communities and schools. If you're going through some challenges, we can help. We have a food pantry. We have services that can help you to support you and help you through challenging times. And I know we've all been through some challenging times this past year as we come out of this really challenging year. We are looking forward to helping our students get back on their feet, get an education, and, you know, again, have a successful career and life. I also wanted to highlight, which is another one of priorities, we're going to have a new facility, a new center at our campus with a health profession center. We are so excited about this. This new building will be ready to go in a late fall semester in the October area, but we'll be offering classes in the spring semester of 2022. So we're very excited. 49,000 square feet building. We're going to house all our health professions programs like dental assisting, dental hygiene, our nursing, occupational therapy, respiratory care. So we're so excited. Be on the lookout for a ribbon cutting at our campus very soon. We're looking forward to inviting the community to embark in this great program, this great center, because we are in demand. We are offering a lot of health professions programs, but we are limited in space. So we're really excited to have a new center to provide more opportunities for our community and for our students. Some of the initiatives really quickly that I want to talk to you about, and I'm going to focus on the third one, which is our laptop program. Students, again, are being challenged financially. And so if you are a student here taking at least 3 hours this summer or 6 hours in the fall semester, we can lend you a computer for you to do your work. You can take it home, do whatever you can, do whatever you want. And if you continue being a student, you just keep the computer with you. So we're helping students with this new technology age that we're in. They can borrow it with no problem, no GPA requirement. We also, you know, partner with MCID, which they're offering $1,600 scholarships for our students. So we want to make sure that they know that we have not just this scholarship, but with the other, we have a lot of financial aid opportunities for our students. So please, you know, don't let that be a barrier to pursue your education. We also have a TRIO grant, which is offering a lot of resources for our students, especially first generation and first time in college students. And of course, our College by Design is for our students who want to pursue business degrees. We have a smoothest transition through that initiative. So we're very excited to be offering these type of opportunities for our community and especially for our students. And finally, I will end with our Kingwood Centers of Excellence. We're so excited that it's not just our Kingwood campus. We do have a campus, a center at Atascocita Center that is on Westlake Houston Parkway. I'm happy to hear that there may be a trail around there. That's amazing. And so we have a full-fledged campus there if you need any classes, and we have for your associate degree or you want to transfer, we have those classes there. And then we also have a Process Technology Center, which offers an AAS, an associate degree in Process Technology and Instrumentation Technology. But we also offer the core classes if you just want to take classes to transfer. And that is located on Lockwood Road, right there in Generation Park, right across Summit Creek High School. So we're very excited to be part of the community, very excited to offer opportunities, educational opportunities to change lives in a way that is going to be amazing, just like education changed my life, coming from a small little town down in the Rio Grande Valley, and now being here in Houston, being part of one of the largest community colleges in the nation, and being here right here in Lowster College Kingwood is a dream of mine and a dream come true. So again, thank you for the opportunity. My name is Melissa Gonzalez. I am the president of Kingwood and a proud individual that lives here, works here, plays here, does business here. And again, I'm just so excited. This is my contact information. Again, looking forward to meeting every one of you. I've already met a lot of great people, but I'm just so excited to be here. And I'm happy that Lone Star College Kingwood is part of the community, and we're here to service you, service our students, and service the community. So thank you so much.
Excellent. Thank you so much. And I love the influence there that, I mean, not only can we live, work, eat, and play here, we can study here as well. And knowing that one of our own, a local Fall Creek resident in this area, is now the president of Lone Star College Kingwood, is amazing and exciting for us. We're so glad you're up there and what you're going to do for the community. Awesome to hear about the health services facility. I mean, this is that's a big top of mind thing for everybody right now after this post-pandemic world that we're still kind of working through, to figure out what that's like and to have more opportunities to help grow those careers and those fields. And that's really cool, that computer program, borrowing those out. I mean, college is expensive, and if that's something that the college can help with, that's really cool. So it's exciting to hear what you've got going on, and thank you for coming in today.
Yes, thank you.
All right, before we hear from our next speakers, we want to offer a little appreciation to each of our gold sponsors. It's through our support that we can educate and update our community on important topics during the BizComs. Thank you very much, all you gold sponsors. First up, Chick-fil-A Wilson Road and Beltway 8 is a proud sponsor of Partnership Lake Houston. In case you didn't know, we now offer delivery through our Chick-fil-A app, and a smiling face from my team will bring it right to your door or your office, wherever you might be. So just click on that Chick-fil-A app and order your lunch right up. HEB has partnered with YMCA Operation Backpack, a program to provide school supplies and backpacks for all the children and communities in our area. The children in our community need us now more than ever. Funds raised will be used to purchase packaged school supplies and backpacks that will be distributed to children in need in our communities across our area. Make a donation at your local HEB, either in store when you're shopping in there or online when you're getting your orders brought to you. Partnership Lake Houston is also privileged to have JLA Realty Team Petrie as a gold sponsor also. Team Petrie needs your homes. Due to the low housing supply and high buyer demand, the Lake Houston area, as well as the rest of the country, is in a true seller's market. This means it's a great time for you to sell your home. Give Team Petrie a call today for your free market valuation and discuss how they can help you with your real estate goals. Whether your school needs t-shirts or your business needs polo shirts and hats, K&S Sportswear can help you. Need promotional items such as koozies, pins, towels, or yard signs? We've got you covered. K&S Sportswear is located on 1960 in Atascocita, and they always want you to remember to shop local. Our other gold sponsor, Redemption Square, is hosting many community events and activities to keep everyone involved this month. From the market that happens every fourth Saturday of the month, and Thursday morning story time for the kids, and to getting our bodies active with yoga and Zumba, and for all you automobile lovers, there's a Cars and Coffee there that showcases classics and other fancy cars, but and everything in between. See redemptionsquare.com for more details. Our other gold sponsors, the University of Texas MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston. It ranks as one of the world's most respected centers focused on cancer patient care, research, education, and prevention. The institution's sole mission is to end cancer for patients and their families around the world. MD Anderson is one of only 51 comprehensive cancer centers designated by the National Cancer Institute and is ranked number one for cancer care in the U.S. News and World Report's Best Hospital Survey. MD Anderson provides cancer care at several convenient locations throughout the greater Houston area. All right, our next speaker today is going to be Brent McDonald, principal of Summer Creek High School. Brent McDonald is going to give us an update about the coming school year for the 2021-22 school year coming up. All right, Brent, what do you got? Okay. All right. We're having a little technical difficulty there with Principal McDonald's update for us. So we're going to jump forward here. We'll come back to his update. So Reese McCall, you're the general manager of the Golf Clubs of Houston, and you're here today to give us a update about what's going on at the Golf Clubs of Houston. Welcome, Reese.
Dwayne, thanks. Thanks for having me, and excited to get to talk to you guys a little bit today about some exciting stuff that we've got going on here at Golf Club of Houston. So looking forward to spending a couple minutes here with you guys. First of all, you know, COVID about 16, 17 months ago, all of us in the golf business had no idea what to expect. You know, just like many businesses, whether or not we'd survive and what was going to happen. Golf is going strong. And we saw that early on in the pandemic. And it's continued for the last 17 months or so. We have seen a surge in golf across the country that we haven't seen since the late 90s and early 2000s with the Tiger Woods era. So golf is going very strong across the board, both on our daily fee side with tournaments and events and public play, as well as our membership base. Just to give you a little kind of example here, prior to COVID, we did about 50,000 rounds here at Golf Club of Houston annually. Last year, we did about 65,000, and we're on pace to do about 65,000 again this year. So definitely a big increase, which has been wonderful here for us at the club for all of us. So golf continues to bounce up. Obviously, we were a very proud 17-year host of the Houston Open. You know, a lot of times we get asked, what does it mean for you guys now that you're not hosting the Open? You know, we hosted it here from 2003 when we hosted it on our member course for the first 3 years, and then it moved over to the tournament course in 2006, excuse me. And we held it for the last time in 2019. Obviously a huge part of our history, something we're very proud of. And it was definitely bittersweet to see that move on and go down to Memorial Park. But really what it's done is it's allowed us to kind of change our business model a little bit and really focus on our membership. And that's truly what we're doing. We are all about our members. And that's all types of members, for a day with our guests, our tournament and outings, and then our members over on our member course as well. So very, very big part of our history, something we're very proud of. But again, it's allowed us to kind of move on and focus in a new direction right now, which we're really excited about. We're excited in the direction that we're headed on both aspects of that. So, you know, we've got a lot of events coming up. Really good to see, you know, a lot of our corporate and charity and partner events that we've hosted annually year after year that had to take a break last year with everything going on in the world. You know, this fall is going to be a very, very busy time for us. It's awesome to see. We've got so many groups that are back with us again that continue with their events moving forward, and they're going to continue to do that. And so It's going to be a really busy time for us in the fall. If you've got a charity outing or a corporate event or anything that you're looking to do, Liz Strong does a phenomenal job for us helping host your event here. We're known for providing world-class service, great golf course conditions. That's one thing without hosting the Houston Open anymore, that we no longer oversee our tournament golf course. And so our course is in phenomenal shape. Really 12 months a year. Brian Buckner, our director of agronomy, has done a fantastic job and continues to keep both courses in just wonderful shape year round. Just touch a quick here, our membership, we've got a strong membership, stronger than ever. We've got our biggest membership base that we've ever had. We continue to add new members. We still have some memberships available. We are starting to get closer to what our capacity is over on the member course. Our members are very active. They enjoy a lot of events on the member course, both golf and social events. Recently, we've been very excited. We've added a kind of new amenity and feature for our membership to use, and that's our short course. It's a little three-hole short course, par three. Really fun to go out with the kids and the family and take them out there. It's you play holes anywhere from 40 yards to 100 yards. Kind of wide open and just a really good opportunity to get out with the family, you know, take some of the younger kids. We've got a lot of our older members that'll go over there and have a little three-hole tournament as well. So it's just kind of a fun, unique addition that we've been able to provide for our membership over the last year or so. And then kind of the last thing real quick to touch on is over in that same area, we're really excited. We've got plans right now to add a state-of-the-art fitness center. We've got about a 6,000 square foot building that is going to be a state-of-the-art fitness center. We're hoping to break ground on that sometime in the next 90 days or so here. But it's going to be a huge amenity, a great addition to our membership. It's going to provide a new type of membership for us as well that we're excited about, kind of a sport type membership that'll include access to all of our social events at the club, the fitness center. And then the big key to the fitness center that we're really excited about is the addition of a kids club as well. And so we'll be able to provide some childcare opportunities so members can come out, come play a round of golf, have the kids be taken care of, come out and join us for some dinner or come out and work out. So we are really excited about the future of the club and can't wait to see what the next couple of years hold here for us. So again, thank you guys for having me. I really appreciate it.
Awesome. Thanks, Reese. It's exciting to hear what's going on and that things are going so well with the golf clubs there. I know in that post tournament world where you always had the Shell Houston Open over there that so many of us Fall Creek residents and stuff in the area were curious how things were going since they left. So we're glad it's going well. And those add-ons there with that eventual kids club and the fitness center, that's going to be great. So we're looking forward to that. And I know corporately, we hosted a Cub Scout thing over there just recently, and Liz's group there took great care of us. So we love using the facility. So looking forward to it, and maybe I'll see you over there for a round of golf pretty soon.
Sounds good. Thanks.
Let's get back to Principal McDonald, and let's hear his update that he's got for us today about what's going to happen at Summer Creek High School and how the year finished up and everything.
Hey, welcome Summer Creek BizCom. Sorry I couldn't make it today. Unfortunately, I'm at a destination with my wife today, but finishing out our summer vacation, getting ready for a great school year, and I kind of want to give an update, focus of what's going on at Summer Creek High School, and I hope everybody's doing well. I know last year was a challenge for everybody with the pandemic. I know especially when it came to the business world, things were difficult. Hopefully your businesses are rebounding, things are better. Just an update on what's going on at Summer Creek High School and things. I'll be entering my fifth year as a building principal here at Summer Creek High School. 4 years ago when I started, we had 2,100 kids. This year, we're over 3,100 kids at Summer Creek High School. So I'm guessing the real estate business is doing quite well in our area. We're seeing people move in, not move out of our area, and thus we're proud of what's going on at Summer Creek High School. So businesses, hopefully you're doing a lot better right now. So last year, with 3,000-ish kids, we had 1,800 kids that were face-to-face. We had 1,200 kids that were virtual, and that was a nightmare. That was something we had to learn right away, and that wasn't the way we intended to do things, but we know what? We learned a lot. This upcoming school year, we're at about 96% of our kids are face-to-face. We have about 100 to 150 kids that are actually still virtual right now, and we're still working with the school board and the TEA and the district what we're going to do, if funding's going to take place. But right now, we're going to take care of all of our students. But we are looking at about 3,000 kids on campus next year, with just a small smidgen of kids that will be virtual next year, trying to meet each individual kid's needs. Some updates on last school year, you know, our fine arts department, our band, our orchestra, our choir, our theater, our dance teams, our visual arts, just had remarkable years with some sweepstakes, with advancing in the UIL competition in theater. But all of our kids are so talented. You have no idea when you look at kids in our hallways what they have intrinsically and the talent they have inside when it comes to fine arts. And then you move into our academics, our advanced academics. Our dual credits are huge here at Summer Creek High School. Our AP push has been amazing. We have, in the last 2 years alone, 15 national merit scholars here at Summer Creek High School. Put that in perspective, our previous 8 years, we had one. And in the last 2 years, we've had 15 national merit scholars. We had the most kids in Humble ISD that took dual credit classes this summer. Dual credit meaning they get their college and high school classes done at the same time. Summer Creek High School is leading the way with dual credit classes on campus and this summer, because our kids are really pushing the envelope of our kids going to great universities and all kinds of things like that. Our tiny home project, huge. We finished our second home already. We're about to take that off our campus and start tiny home number 3, which will be donated to a homeless veteran. And then our athletics, obviously, is something we love to focus in on here. We're excited about our new gymnasium, our new facilities in baseball, in softball, our new weight room, our new athletic locker rooms. We won another state championship in boys track. We're so proud of our guys. And our girls, if you didn't know, finished 6th in the state of Texas. So our track programs are second to none, honestly. Coach Irvin won a 2nd state championship at Summer Creek High School. Our basketball team, our girls team, made it to the regional tournament again 4 years in a row. Our boys made it to the regional tournament again in boys basketball. And we lost at the buzzer to Atascocita. We're proud of them making it to state. But we were like a quarter of a second from making it to state in boys basketball. And we return almost everybody. Our basketball teams will be great again this year. So we look forward to our team this year, to our teams this year. Some focuses we have this upcoming school year is we really want to look and make sure we're getting back to educating our students outside of Schoology, direct instruction, academic conversations in the classroom. But our main focus is personalized counseling in Humble ISD at Summer Creek High School, so that every student will meet with their counselor at least twice a year to look at their plan and their future and what they want to do outside of Summer Creek High School. So we're looking forward to, we're back, having our kids back on campus, pep rallies, dances, and having all the fun things that happen in the interactions and the welcome back to Summer Creek High School. So guys, have a great year. We'll see you face-to-face with BizCom in a couple weeks. But guys, welcome back to Summer Creek High School and go Bulldogs.
Awesome, and we're so thankful that Principal McDonald gave us that update and filmed that for us. He's enjoying some much needed vacation. It's been a journey for us all to work through this, but I can imagine being the principal of 3,000-ish students needing a break here in the summer. So thank you for making time for us and giving us that update. We're excited. There's a lot of amazing students over there at Summer Creek. So last but not least, we have an update here about Partnership Lake Houston. Of course, we're excited to bring back the 29th annual Partnership Golf Classic and Party on the Green. These are very exciting events for us. So both these events are going to be in person, and they're going to be held at the clubs of Kingwood. Brooke, I know I always enjoy going to these events. What do you have planned for us, Brooke?
So thank you for that. Yes, I think people are super excited to get out and get back to in-person events. So I'm going to share my screen for just a second to give a couple quick updates. So as Dwayne just shared, the Partnership Golf Classic is back, and the presenting sponsor is HCA, Houston Healthcare Kingwood. So we want to thank them for stepping up as presenting sponsor again. The date of the tournament is Monday, September 13th, with an 11 a.m. shotgun start at the clubs of Kingwood. Carol Poston will be your contact for sponsorships. A lot of the sponsorships are already sold out, but there are opportunities for you to get your business exposure. So contact Carol if you're interested. And there are some teams and player spots available. Teams are $1,000 and individual golfers are $250, but we do have some limitations there, of course. We're getting close to that date. It's exciting. And then next with Party on the Green, we want to thank our presenting sponsor, First Financial Bank. They're stepping up to sponsor again, and we're back at the Clubs of Kingwood on Saturday, September 25th at 6:30 p.m. Now, if you will remember from our virtual event last year, Party on the Screen, in addition to cornhole, we added in the axe throwing tournament. And so that will be back again this year. So it'll be the second annual Lake Houston Cornhole and Axe Throwing Championship. So we're super excited about that. All of the other things that we all love about Party on the Green, great food and drinks, great people we get to visit with, bid board and auction, and that after party that we all look forward to. So again, there are some sponsorships available there. Carol Poston will be your contact for that. And tickets are $100 each. Teams of two are also $100 each. So we're looking forward to getting back in person, getting back with these signature events. Look forward to seeing everyone in September at one of these two events. Thank you so much.
Awesome. It is exciting to get back in person and have these events that we've always enjoyed. So thanks for putting that together. All right, we got some final thank yous to do. We want to absolutely say thank you here to Sam and his team here at DNA Studios. They've done a great job pulling off all these BizComs for us virtually and helping us continue these great updates for our community. And then, of course, our gold sponsors, we couldn't do it without them. Chick-fil-A, Wilson Road, Beltway 8, HEB Summer Creek, JLA Realty with Amanda Petrie, KA&S Sportswear, McCord Development, Generation Park, and MD Anderson Cancer Center. Our silver sponsors, of course, PostNet Summerwood and Shell Federal Credit Union. Thank you to all our sponsors. We can't do this without y'all. Thank you for helping us make all these possible. Got some final final notes here we have. So thanks for joining us today. We've had some great events planned for the rest of the summer. So hopefully you can join us for the inaugural Leadership Awards Luncheon presented by Team Petrie, which will honor the Outstanding Alumni Award. And it'll also honor our top 4 under 40 of the Lake Houston area. On July 20th is that event. August 5th, we will have Kingwood BizCom presented by HCA Healthcare Kingwood and Rosewood Funeral Home. On August 26th, we're gonna have Focus on the Federal presented by Planet Ford of Humble, and the luncheon will feature US Congressman Dan Crenshaw. And of course, we have a little drum roll, please. We're bringing back Network After Hours. Is going to be back on August 19th. It's going to be at Sullivan's Truck and Auto and Collision. So hopefully you can join us there also. Thanks again for joining us today, and we look forward to seeing you next time.